Onlangs hadden we een ontmoeting met Alice. Ze is een alleenstaande moeder die we in het kader van het GRACE-project geholpen hebben met een opleiding tot verpleegkundige. Ze groeide op in een onveilige omgeving en werd al heel jong moeder. Ze hield een traumatische ervaring over aan de onlusten na verkiezingen in december 2008 en moest op de vlucht voor verder geweld. Nu werkt ze in het noordoosten van Kenia, in een dorpje niet zo ver van de grens met Somalië, ongeveer 180 kilometer ten zuiden van het vluchtelingenkamp Dadaab. En het gaat goed met haar.
So Alice, you started your job in January of this year after your education.
Yes.
So what is the place where you are based now?
I'm based at Ijara district. It is in northeastern province.
Okay, and the place where you are, how is that called?
It's called Masalani.
And what type of people are living there?
The people that are living there are Somalis. Uh-huh. Many people are angry there, but the government usually supply them with food monthly.
So you don't have people, let me say, who are really starving to death or something?
Not really. Most people in that area, they are herdsmen. They keep cattle, donkeys, sheep and goats.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then they sell them the animals for meat or something?
No, they don't sell. Most of them just keep them. They use the milk.
Yeah, and they eat them themselves as well, or not really?
Yeah, they usually eat.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So that means that the economy in that area is still at a very low pace or something?
Yeah, it's still very low. Yeah, there is not a lot of trading.
No
industry.
Yeah.
The place that I'm working, it's dry because we had rains. It was on March. We had rain. Uh-huh. And then since then we've not had rain.
Okay.
And last week it was just drizzle. So that place it's dry.
Yeah.
Huh. But along the River Tana, uh-huh, there is irrigation there.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's where they get their vegetables from? And
yeah, that's where they get their vegetables from.
And like shops, are there many in that town or not really?
Not really.
Okay.
Yeah, but most of the thing I usually buy in Garissa town because Garissa town is a bit big.
Yeah.
So that when I go to the place that I'm working, at least I have something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And like when you are going there, traveling there, how long will it take you?
From here to Nairobi is around 6 hours.
Yeah.
And then Nairobi to Garissa, 6 hours.
Yeah.
And then I sleep in Garissa town.
Uh-huh.
And then from Garissa to the place that I'm working, uh-huh, is 4 hours. To the small center where I am, it's four hours.
Yeah.
And then from there, I take another vehicle, 18 kilometers now. There is one house with 3 rooms and then I share with my colleague. We are 3, 2 nurses and 1 community health worker.
Okay.
So the community health worker lives at home, uh-huh, in their home, and then 2 of us, we live in one house.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And what are your plans for the future?
For the future, God willing, I want to advance my studies,
uh-huh,
and then when I advance, I would like to come nearer. See, and you know, it's good to stay with the son so that coaching him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. But anyway, you are still happy with the step you have taken?
Yes, I'm very happy.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. And I thank you very much for the for the fire that you've brought me.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
No, thank you very much, and
thank
God bless you.
You,
and I hope that you really will succeed also in the plans that you have, and we hope to see you around here again, and now as a nurse. Eh?
Thank you very
that
much.
That will be very nice.
Yeah, I'm also very happy, and I thank God for the fact that I've come, because since I was young, I wanted to become a nurse, because even in school, they were asking me, what do you want to be? I say, I want to be a nurse.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you very much.